Welcome back, everybody. I have a special video for you today. It's the HP Omen 15 2020, and you're at CE Tech Tips. So today's video is really about unboxing a new laptop. I'm searching for a notebook for my wife where she can do some writing. We can also have some multi-purpose for some gaming, and something that gives us some decent battery life, but a little bit of fun with the gaming as well. So let's get unboxing this. This unit is the i7-10750. It has 16 gigs of RAM, 1 terabyte SSD, and it also features the 2070 Super Max-Q along with a 15.6 inch display, 144 hertz, and includes G-Sync. So I'm really excited to test this out. Also features a 70.9 watt hour battery, so it should give me plenty of battery life. This is the Omen here. Very fancy. Got a little bit of the congratulations on purchasing your Omen. Oh, that's going to be nice. And look at that unit there. What else kind of goodies do we have in here today? Use a power brick. Laptop and a power brick. What more do you need? What's nice about this power brick is it is slim and nice. Fits in your hand nicely. Get that plugged in. Very non-nonsense packaging, just gets you right into it. So let's look at this unit here. So some of the criteria that I was looking at for the Omen was something that was decent, lightweight enough, something that had the performance, and also look at this unit here. Wow. Well, first impressions is this looks great, guys. This is an impressive unit. Feels sturdy. You gotta love when you can open it up with one hand. That's a great feature. Has some weight on the bottom. Got this great emblem here that is subtle, but still knows that you got something special underneath this. So taking a look at the ports, decent selection of ports, USB-C, mini display port out, 2 USBs. And then on the other side, we have SD card, headphone out, HDMI, a powered USB, and a nice network jack, and of course we have our power. So let's open this up, let's see what's inside. We have our battery, nice large battery at 70 watt hour. We have dual channel 8 gig modules, the SODIMMs here, both upgradable. We're seeing a lot of actual modules now being soldered on the board, and then you only have one module, and even some that actually only come with one module, reducing the performance of your memory. So it's nice to see that there's two modules right here in the unit itself. We have two fans on the back, and then heat pipes running through to keep everything cool. We got some upgradable modules here for the M.2 SSD. One's populated here, that's our 1 terabyte, and this one over here is our spare. But overall, nice to see upgradability, extra slot for your M.2, and the memory modules here. Love it. Let's turn this sucker on.
Doman 15 ranged around 35 decibels at idle, ramping up to roughly 50 decibels under load. I saw this in benchmarks and in games, but never came close to the 60 decibels that was able to measure when the fans were at max. From a power consumption standpoint, this was pulling around 145 watts from the wall, well under the 200 watt limit. Range from 30 degrees Celsius to a peak of 40 degrees Celsius, but was still very comfortable. In Modern Warfare, I saw around an average of 120 to 125 frames per second.
So I've had the notebook now for 24 hours. It has been it's been great so far. One of the things that I've noticed right off the hop is that the battery life in many of these gaming notebooks just isn't sufficient. Even running Netflix on battery, it lasted about 4 hours of continuous play, 4.5 hours. Gaming-wise, about 90 minutes if you're maxing everything out. You may be able to move the settings around to get a little bit more life out of it, but that's what I'm seeing. One of the unique things that I found about this unit, though, is how well the thermals are. It actually keeps it relatively quiet. The fans can actually spool all the way up to 60 decibels when they're fully maxed, which is pretty loud. So definitely if you're going to be gaming on something like this, you want to be using a headset. Definitely one that goes over your ears so you're fully immersed in the gaming experience. The interesting thing about the spec on this is I was actually anticipating getting a 2070, and this actually came through with a 2070 Supermax Q, and it's actually great value for the money. You can pick it up for about $1,500. So what would my recommendation be? Well, you know, when I look at this after you know, going through running some of the software, it does give some great performance. I love the screen. It's a G-Sync screen as well, giving you that 144 hertz, about 300-350 nits of brightness. And, you know, for me, I would recommend it. Great value for the money. A lot of the other things I'm seeing out there either have less storage or less of a graphics card. So the true test is actually when I start putting some of these through the benchmarks and see whether or not the thermals inside some of these other units actually can hold their own. So stay tuned for that. I actually have a couple more units I'm gonna be testing. I have the 2019 chassis version, very similar spec. We'll be testing that shortly. And then I also have the ASUS ROG Strix, and we'll be testing out that. I anticipate this one to actually have better thermals for cooling, but we'll have to wait and see. So if you like this video, please like or subscribe. Leave a comment down below. I am passionate about technology, love to share. Hope you found this video beneficial, and till next time, bye for now.